All right, let's see what's going on here.
It's flashing.
Back there. Who was the genius who put it back there?
So the hot water will go. I'm turning it on. It'll eventually. And then 111 starts to flash.
I think that's flame failure if I'm not mistaken.
Let's give it a second.
Yeah, right now it's...
It's still like not getting hot.
At 111. Actually, let's talk. When was it installed?
It was installed in 2020 or 2021.
So about 5 years old. Okay. And I take it it's... who installed it? Plumber?
Yes.
Really?
Plumbing.
Okay. Did they tell you needed any service? I'm sorry to hear that. And the drain just goes into your drain in the ground. Okay, so there's a few things wrong with the installation. We'll start with that, but we'll address what the flame error is. You have a tankless water heater, and it's a box, obviously, that hangs on the wall, and it instantaneously flash heats the water. So as water passes through it, it heats the water on demand. They're great. They're energy efficient. They save space because real estate is very valuable, right? I wish it wasn't installed where it is because we have to take apart the vent piping for the boiler to get to it. But with tankless water heaters, you need to what we call descale them on an annual basis.
Now there's
and I know they probably don't even know about that because the valves that you need to have. That need to be there are not there. There are valves that go underneath, like similar to the valve you have, the two valves, the hot and cold valves you have there now, but allows you to hook up, you know, hoses and a pump to flush the chemical through it. That way you can remove the scale and buildup that happens because the water is not that great. That's the primary thing. Secondary is this drain here. This is what we call a condensing boiler, because you notice it, like your condensing water heater, if you notice, like your boiler uses your chimney with that steel metal pipe, but the water heater has two pipes, which are plastic, PVC, because the temperature of the exhaust is much lower than a traditional water heater, or even like a boiler. Mm-hmm. So because of the low, and I hope I'm not confusing you, but...
You're speaking a different language.
I know.
But,
but because of the lower exhaust temperature, the water or the condensate that it creates, which is why that pipe, that white pipe goes into your drain, is very acidic.
Okay.
And that acid basically will eat wherever it's going into if it's metal, if it's type of metal pipe. Just keep that in mind. We have to get to the front of that unit. I got to disconnect the exhaust for the boiler and then it's still tight, but we'll get to it.
Okay.
Okay. It's going to take a little bit of time though. The hourly labor rate is $225, and hopefully I could do this in about an hour for you. If not, and it takes longer, we'll get to that point. But the 111 is a flame failure error. Not igniting.
All right, let's end that call for heat. Kill power. Let's take a peek in there. No bueno. Let's get in there a little bit better. Right on there. Come on, baby. There we go. Perfect. Beautiful. Screws back in. I'm gonna need a new gasket, but let's just see if we can get this up and running first. Okay. Okay. Everything's back in. Turn the power back on. Let's see what happens. All right, after about 20 seconds, we're in standby. Let's energize. Nope. Looks like it's gonna be maybe ignition issue. Ignition transformer. Domestic hot water. Let's remove the ignition transformer from the right side of the heat exchanger. There it is. Let's get a voltmeter and see if we have voltage here. All right. Two purple wires going to the voltage transformer disconnected here. Let's turn the power on. Let's let it do a reboot cycle. Okay, wait for standby. Come on, there we go, standby. Okay, voltmeter, 2.2 volts. Yeah, we get voltage to the ignition transformer. Yep. Yeah, we get voltage there. So this ignition transformer is good. All right, power is off. Let's see if the gas valve's opening. There's our gas valve. Let's remove. Let's go here. Make sure the gas is on. Let's see what we got there. All right, back in standby mode. It needs to see that. All right, let's check gas pressure. Okay. Okay. Turn that back on. For it to go on standby. Okay. 6.5. I'm not moving. Together, everything back the way it was.